We started thinking about taxes, and especially this time of year, because everybody starts thinking about taxes this time of year. And we started asking a few questions, and we're really surprised when we found out that a lot of Americans think it's okay to cheat on their taxes. 15% of Americans actually admit that they've cheated on their taxes in the past. The tax gap is the difference between the number that the IRS thinks it should be taking in every year and what they actually do collect. And that difference is about $300 billion a year. That's a massive number. And they realize that they could be chopping away at the deficit if they had these numbers. The IRS is way more sophisticated than you probably realize. There is a National Crime Lab in Chicago, and if you've ever seen CSI, that should give you a good indication of what's happening at this National Crime Lab. They have lasers that can track down and see if your fingerprints have ever landed on any tax document. They've got an entire library of every ink that's ever been created so that they can figure out if you claimed that you signed that document, let's say back in 1986, but the penmanship on it, the pen, the actual ink, wasn't invented until 1988. They can track things down that way to see if you're backdating issues. Don't think that just because someone's telling you something is legal that it necessarily is. If you listen to bad advice from a tax accountant who either doesn't know the law or who is hoodwinking you, you are responsible. It's your signature that goes on the IRS document. So there have been cases, including some of the people that we talked to, where they had accountants tell them that this was a completely legitimate way of doing their taxes. They got back returns that were much larger than you might think was legal, and that should be the tip-off or a big red flag for you. If you're getting back more money than you thought was possible, well, it probably wasn't legal. So you should double-check that, and just because an accountant gives you that information doesn't mean that you're not going to be the one who's on the hook, facing potentially jail time and certainly facing a big, big bill when it comes to the taxes and the back pay and the interest that goes along with that. You'll see these big high-profile cases that the IRS goes after. You see things like Ja Rule. You see Al Pacino, who's run into some trouble with this. Willie Nelson is a very well-known case from the past. And Wesley Snipes, who's in prison right now because of not paying his taxes. Those are not the only people that the IRS targets, but those are the cases that get the big headlines. And that helps them, too, by reminding people that, yeah, no one is above the law. And if we find you, it doesn't matter who you are. They're going to go after you to the full extent of the law.